Vilex MiniRails are external fixators used in hand and foot surgeries. They are ideal for the revision of a failed surgery, for example, mal or non-union, distraction of an impacted joint, or bone lengthening using osteogenesis, to name a few. In this procedure, we'll demonstrate the use of a Vilex MiniRail to lengthen the first metatarsal. The first step is to decide on the sizes of the rail and the half pins and the positioning of the half pins. We prepare the selected rail by loosening the stationary carriage and repositioning the traveling carriage midway along the rail. Slightly loosen the locking screws for easier insertion of the half pins through the clamp openings. It is advisable to insert the half pins before making the osteotomy. With a surgical pen, mark the desired location for the two half pins, one on each side of the proposed osteotomy. The pins should be about 25 millimeters apart. Establish the location of the osteotomy. Make sure that the two distal pins avoid the metatarsal head, while the proximal pins can capture the second met or even the first cuneiform. Use a 1.6 millimeter K-wire where the first proximal pin will be. Position the wire perpendicular to the bone surface. The wire is used to puncture the cortex. Remove the wire and insert the first half pin. Repeat the procedure for the second pin. Attempt to drive the wire parallel to the first half pin. It is desirable, but not essential, to place all four pins exactly parallel to each other and in the same plane. The first two pins can be off as much as 30 degrees from each other. With the two pins in place, slide the rail over the two pins. Position the traveling carriage distally and then engage the stationary carriage. Tighten the screw on the bottom of the stationary carriage. This carriage must not move. Introduce the remaining two half pins using the rail itself as a template, adjusting the clamp openings as necessary. Avoid excessive loosening of the clamps. Tighten the screws without locking them to allow the rail body free movement so that it can be aligned parallel to the metatarsal shaft. The screws should be loose enough to make the adjustment. Holding the foot with one hand, adjust the orientation of the rail axis so it is parallel to the direction of distraction or compression, as the case may be. Next, loosen the clamps enough to remove the mini rail while leaving the pins in place. Make a small incision and expose the bone. Mark the osteotomy location. When making the cut, make sure that the periosteum remains intact. Extend the incision to facilitate access. With an osteotome, make sure the distal fragment is totally free. Notice that the pins are introduced first, before making the mid-shaft cut. This will ensure that the compression and distraction of the two fragments will remain collinear without any dorsiflexion or plantar flexion. Re-engage the mini rail to the pins and gently tighten the two locking screws on top by hand. Again, tighten the screws without locking them. This allows the rail body free movement so that it can be aligned parallel to the metatarsal shaft. Adjust the positioning of each pin using the multi-purpose tool, advancing or retracting as necessary. There is no loss of purchase if a pin is retracted. Holding the foot with one hand, adjust the position and orientation of the rail axis to be parallel to the direction of distraction or compression, as the case may be. The rail should be positioned about 15 millimeters away from the foot to allow for possible swelling following surgery. With the orientation established, hold the position while an assistant locks the half pins carriages. Use an Allen wrench, distract and reclose the osteotomy, and watch how the bone surfaces compress toward each other. To initiate osteogenesis, begin by compressing the osteotomy firmly for a few days before controlled distraction is initiated. Close and suture normally.